welcome to Tea Time Season 2. Today's episode has a French theme. Enjoy. start the show with a bang. That was Racer X with Fire of Rock and the awesome, awesome Paul Gilbert shredding up the guitar of Mr. X fame. And before that we had Unglavitify. I don't know who that was, but well, it says Kenichi Takoi, which is what it says on the CD. But whether or not it's him, or not, I don't know, somebody in the IRC will tell me later on. Anyway, welcome to Tea Time. This is episode 201. Officially the first episode of season 2. If you were tuned in last week, you would have heard the first episode go out, which is pretty good. So I'm going to keep that format. Hello to all those nice people listening in, and hello to everyone who's loitering in the chat room. That's Joshua Delayed, who says he's still in SSR, but it is a lie. Chris LSNK, Laurie AA, Biafra, D'Artagnan, Falk, Hypersonic, JJF, Phoenix, Wright, Rattleman, Rolko Pop, Cyber Guy, Sky Shock, Sonic, Speednux, D'Avion, with me, and the Belt. For today, because I am in twins. There you go. Turbo, Urtheart, and VJet. Welcome to what will probably be a not very French themed show. I did lie. But there will be some mention of the French later on, because I know like. Anyway, the news this week. There's been lots of stuff going down, as always. The big news, which was already covered in the Sonic area beforehand, which was Mr. Dreadnox, Mr. Rory Black, and a Lady Girl. A Lady Girl, Mr. Dreadnox is Lady Girl. Hello to Mrs. Lady Girl. Sega did not launch that Dreamcast site, which so many people have been waving their arms about going. The question posed by this site was, do you still own a Dreamcast? And a lot of people went, well, why do you want to know if I still own a Dreamcast? And I think due to the fact that Sega still released the odd Dreamcast game, a lot of people signed up to it. You had to put your serial code in from your Dreamcast, and you got yourself an email address, which was really just a very poor Gmail account, really. Anyway, it had a lot to do with IP. Some people sussed it out. It's a hoax. So if you're listening to this, don't sign up to it, because you'll feel like a divvy if you do. The Sonic Chronicles site is open. Go and check it out. That's SegaEurope.com. If you haven't been there yet, what's your problem? www.sega-europe.com. Go there. You can check out all the other Sonic games that are coming out in the future, or that are already out. M&S, Mario and Sonic at the Olympics has now passed 5 million, I don't know, lots of copies selling, it's flying, it's doing really well, and I think people are kind of surprised, but no, I'm not surprised. I think it's a good game, it's a very good party game, and if you haven't already bought it either on the Wii or DS, I sincerely urge you go out and do it, because they're both very fun games, especially if you've got lots of friends. Yes, as I said before, there are Sonic plushies. Yeah, you are right. Turbo says, Biffra, yeah, you are right. Wrong, T. What am I wrong about? Tell me what I am wrong about. Let me know what I am wrong about. I do not know. Anyway, there are the Sonic and Tails plushies, which are at Game. You can go and find them at Game. Set you back £9.99. And if you're extremely eagle-eyed, hawk-eyed, you can find yourself a Knuckles as well. I have no idea what's happened to the Eggman. There is an Eggman advertised on the back of the box. I have not seen one yet. So if you do see one, let me know, or let any of the other TSS staff know, and we'll make a post. And then people can go and look for one, because a lot of people will want them. A lot of people like the retro Sonic stuff that is basically being produced. I can't remember the name of the company who's making them at the minute, but they're pretty good. There's some figures coming out in the not-too-distant future as well, and they look pretty spiffy. They're on the Forbidden Planet website for pre-order if you don't think you can wait. T. Eggman has not been released yet. I know, I said Eggman has not been released. Anyway, moving on. For those of you who are interested in the goings-on of the Sega community, the Lex Factor results, which was the Sonic karaoke competition launched by... Oh, I'm getting two links. Biffra said, I said that in the chat, your French accents are as French as a French kiss. Interesting. And we're always sent me a link. Anyway, yes, the Sonic Rex Factor results were announced with, I don't know, with very mixed, very mixed reception. Look down this. Trippy and Digi from www.nightsdreams.com won outright by a hop, skip and a jump with their remix of Dreams Dreams. Which they've been working on it for years and years, so I think they cheated. Plus there was two of them, so that's not fair. They cheated. Anyway, they won the competition. I came a mighty second. Thank you for voting, if you voted for me. And the judges were all very, they were all very nice to me. Even Jay, you know, Jay said he wasn't going to be, but you know. There you go. And Violet came third. And guess who came last? Yes, it was Mr. Dreadnox and Mr. Rory Black. And they apparently have to do the DK rap. Now, we did do the DK rap, it would have been half a year ago. In fact, we sang the DK rap on Tea Time episode 101, which is the very first episode that went out. And it was slightly out of sync due to the fact that he's 350 miles away. And the song is to get there and then get back. But never mind, he sang that anyway. So I can understand he doesn't want to sing it again. And to be honest, I don't think many people want to hear it again. So, Dread, do something else. Do the pogo rap. Do the pogo rap. I'll listen to the pogo rap. In fact, I'll come in and rap on the pogo rap. If you should need that. Moving it down. Oh, yes. There was also the all-comers results announced. And Iris and Anime Girl won that. Now, I know Iris and Anime Girl. We actually go back longer than the time that I've been on TSS, because I know them from JunsonNow.com, and their entries were really stunning. I mean, I'd say the favourite out of my two was Iris's entry, and they were just fantastic, and I think they should be upgraded next year to the All-Stars, because they are amazing. Dreadnook says, bah, I don't care about losing. I don't care about losing. I'm not going to try the Essex accent. I care about being completely rinsed every 5 minutes, which is true. He did get rinsed every 5 minutes, but that's Mr. AAUK. He likes to poke fun, and he pokes, and he pokes, and he pokes, and pokes a little bit more. And meh. But the thing is, it's only a game. It's only a game. So anyway, next year, apparently, this is already planned, it's March, and this is November, December time. Next year's competition is supposed to be the theme. Well, there's supposed to be a continuing theme, and the theme is duets. So you need to grab yourself a partner, boy, and do yourself a duet. So if you don't have any friends, you're a bit buggered. If you do have friends, hey, you can do a duet. And Mr. AUK was like, oh, me and T-Bird are going to do a duet. We're going to sing Sonic Drive. And I was like, oh, really? Are we? Are we really? I didn't know about this. So apparently that's what's happening, but you know. We just need to wait and see, because it's months away yet, so you've got plenty of time to think of what song you're going to absolutely destroy. And then destroy it. Dredd says, he's a perky man. And how did he ever lose? Well, the thing that got me about that was, it has to be fixed, because there's no way Dredd and Rory would get the same score, you know. When's that going to happen? That was fixed. So you can call a giant hacks on that. That's enough talking for to now, because I want to talk about something else after the break. I'm going to play you now a track from a rather marvelous album all the way back in the day, 1994. This band are still going strong to the day. In fact, they've just released an album over on their website, which is free to download. Nine Inch Nails' Ghost. I've downloaded it. It's pretty good if you like the instrumental stuff that Trent Reznor dreams up, if you should be into that electronica crap. But I'm not going to play you anything from that. I'm going to play you a good old classic from back in the day, 1984. This is off the album Downward Spiral. This is Nine Inch Nails with the rather marvellous banging track Heresy. Enjoy, kiddies. We'll be right back. was High Justice Zone Act 2 from Sonic the Hedgehog 3. Well, the Sega Genesis or the Mega Drive, depending on which way you swing. And before that was Nine Inch Nails with their track Heresy, which I quite like, but it's caused some, oh my god, I don't like this track, in the IRC. I was just trying to figure out what type of music Girl K is. I don't know what Girl K is, so let me know, please. That would be nice. Anyway, if most of you listen to this show, you'll know that I usually talk about something for a long time at this point. And I'm going to talk about something very long at this point, and that is the Vote a Name competition to name the new alien species in the Sonic Chronicles The Dark Brotherhood game that will be hitting the shops in the autumn. And there's a long tale, and I'm going to tell you the tale. About 3 weeks ago, Mr. AUK of Ava fame, apparently, and also works for Sega, approached me and a few other guys and girls of the Sega world and asked us how we would feel about putting forward a name for a new enemy race in the Sonic universe. And at first it took me by a surprise, just for the fact that, you know, this is Sega we're talking about, and who usually don't really listen to what the fans have to say or don't have too much input, and have gone from, you know, being in that state to this October inviting us down to play games and now asking us to name an alien race. So anyway, me and Echo Hawk, if you know who she is, she works over at Sonic Rex with me from time to time. Me and her were asked to generate a name, as were Mr. Dreadnoughts and Mr. Roy Black, and several hundred other people on various community forums and other places around the internet. Now, we were sent the concept art for this alien, and we already knew the name. We knew the name was called the Tyxis, but I think somebody at Sega had just said, somebody over at Sega Japan had said, oh, this name is going to be a bit hard for some people to pronounce. Can you generate another name that, you know, would be better than this? And of course, the rules changed every 5 minutes. We were then told that the name had to be 8 letters long a few days later, and then we were told the name might not be used, and then we were told, generate two names, just in case they don't like your first name. Now, the one thing that stuck in my mind at first, after sort of having to peel myself off the ceiling, because it was a very exciting prospect, I thought, right, well, first off, what's going to make a winning name? We're going to need to have a good name, obviously, but we're also going to need a name that is going to be pretty much universal. So, strange enough, me and Echo both hit on the same idea, and we both thought, right, let's start in Latin. So, we started brainstorming names in Latin. And they went from everything to everything. We went from words like destroy, which is eradicos, so we nearly called them the eradicos. We like the word fort. I don't know what it was about that, but we like the fort word, which obviously is strong in Latin. And we were trying to get from one word to another, so we've got Fortitix was one of our names, and Dark was another name, which is funny because a lot of other people went along those lines and thought, you know, we want a Dark name, but they had only got the outline, and this is what really annoys me, the fact that some people hadn't actually seen the actual concept art, but were generating names for it, especially things like the BioWare forums, anyway. And so we went from Cold, which we got Fridges. I'll give you a few examples, right? Mundus, Immortus, Pulsus, Lacertus, Cridelis, Quantus, and of course in the middle of all of these, I've still got this bit of paper with all the names written down on it. There's hundreds and hundreds of names. And right in the middle, which I've circled in big letters, is Gravitus. And Gravitus derives from the Latin, which is gravitas, which means something that is heavy. And by George, this alien certainly does look like he's heavy. So we changed a few of the letters around, made it sound a little bit more funky and cool. We were going to go for Gravitix. Decided, maybe not. You know, the X doesn't really add to the whole name of it. So we decided both unanimously on Gravitus. Close second, which I know Mr. Dreadnoughts liked a lot, was the word Anomalix, which we obviously got from Anomaly. Neo flip reversed it to make it sound a little bit cooler. But anyway, we submit those names and they went forward. And as you know, you'll know all the other names. BioWare submitted the Dusk, you know, Sven and Rory submitted the name the Psycho. And so the 10 names were assembled on the website. And if you haven't been to the website, go there now and vote. You can vote Gravitas if you want, that'd be very nice. But when you're voting, think of a good name. It's going to be a good name, and that's my quota for this. You know, this is my I would rather you chose a name that you felt would be more suitable rather than just, oh yes, Dreadnox has done this name, or T-Bird has done this name, I will vote for this one. Don't do that. Vote for a name that you think will be good and suits the alien for starters, because we don't want another Black Arms. Never mind. Anywho, so get over to Sega Europe. I think Sega, if you go to the Sega Europe site, it is down at the minute. I'll go to the Sonic City. Yes, Urtheart's very kindly put the link in the IRC. web.sega-europe.com/Sonic City or one word /index.html, and you will be at the site and you'll be able to vote. You'll be able to choose from the names. Now, me and Dreadnox had me, Dreadnox, Rory, a couple of other people had a good laugh at the French names, because to be honest, you know, I'm going to say there's a couple of names out there which I will just laugh at if they win, and I'm not sure that it's just the fact that, you know, it just all has got lost in the language barrier, but the French have come up with a couple of really weird names, the Dark Nude being one of them, and what was it, the Blue Chaos, or the Blue Chow, so whatever, I kind of pronounce it, but it's a really good laugh at that. Unfortunately, there's been a couple of French people visit TSS in it, and have seen this mocking, and haven't been too happy about it. So anyway, I thought, right, I'm going to promote the Gravitas until it's coming out of my ears. So I headed over to Facebook, made a Facebook group. If you're on Facebook, you can add me. And join the site and vote for me. That'd be great, because you know we like waving our arms and making as much noise as we can. So anyway, I decided, right, I'm gonna go to Sega Nerds and I'm gonna go to Sonic Online, which is the French site, and I'm gonna make a bit of a song and dance so that people can see me and go, oh, this is the man who made this name, we should vote for him. Unfortunately, due to a couple of language barriers, the fact that I don't speak French as my first language, and the fact that Babelfish is completely useless from time to time, it was a bit of a language barrier. So I posted a message, and it was along the lines of, hey guys, good luck with the competition, I made this name, vote for me if you think it's good. And literally, all the other replies on this website are like, oh, you stupid English, huh, your language is shit, and your names are rubbish. And they even go on to mock Sonic Rex, which is pretty hilarious. And that's how that's gone. But anyway, Sega Nerds did the same, they basically told me to piss off, but you know. I laugh at Sega Nerds. I don't really. Their name is The Dusk. If you think that is a good name, then vote for The Dusk. Spinox says we've got the link to the Sonic Online place. It is www.soniconline, all one word, .fr. And that should take you to the set, and you'll be able to have a look at it. Anyway, yes, if you haven't voted yet, get your ass over there and vote. Because every vote does count, and I think it will count in the end. So you have until this Friday, which would be the 15th to vote. I think it's the 15th. No, the 14th. We've got this Friday, which is the 14th, to vote. And on Saturday, the name will be announced. Oh, Sega Nerds are all hyped up at the fact that their name is Azoa. And it's basically stolen from another game. This is the thing that gets me about the Sega Nerds game. Okay, fair enough. It's alright. I thought it was quite an original name, but it's actually... stolen is a strong word. It is taken from the game Panzer Dragoon, in which there was a forest called the Zoa, or whatever, I don't know. Never mind. But if you want to vote for Crushers, you can vote for the Crushers. If you want to vote for the Guardians, you can vote for the Guardians. It's up to you. Dreadnook says Zoa is Noa for me. Oh, that's almost banner worthy, but never mind. We won't do that. Because we play nice. We play nice, don't worry, Mr. Dreadnox. Anyway. Should play you some more music. I played you Ungravity Fire at the beginning of the show, because I finally got around to playing Sonic Riders CG, and I actually quite like it. The one thing that really annoyed me about the first Sonic Riders was that you cornered like a cow in a shopping trolley on ice. It was basically, if you went in a direction, you weren't going to turn anywhere very fast. And they've eradicated that now with that horrible, well, with this, not horrible, but this, with this lovely gravity system where you collect GP by doing tricks and doing various other things, collecting GP as you go around the course, stopping yourself at a corner, going into sort of a bullet time mode, and then catapulting yourself in a direction in which you choose. I really like that, especially towards the end of the game when you're in places like the Crimson Tower. It just makes the game so much fun to fly off the end, stop all this crap happening, and then catapult yourself back. I really like that. My two biggest niggles about the game is tricking's gone, which I'm a bit upset about, because I quite like tricking in the first Sonic game, the Sonic Riders. And my other niggle is the fact that the game is now completely opposite end of the scale of Sonic Riders, which was far too hard. It is now far too easy, and I got through the game first time on every level. So I've literally completed the game in, what, maybe an hour? Not even that. So it should have been a little bit harder, but you know, never mind. At least it wasn't incredibly difficult like the first one. There's been a lot of conversation in the chat room about what type of music do you like. So if you want to talk about the music that you like, you can go there and talk. And I'm going to go and join them now while I play you a couple of music. I'm going to play you this track by Fumi Katadudi, which is Gadget Round from Sonic Riders ZG, followed by ZZ Top, We'll Go With Wood, and then followed by something that Mr. Rory the Coon has sent me, a track by Barrington Levy, and the name, which eludes me, I'll tell you afterwards. Anyway, it's pronounced like Levi. Alright, Barrington Levy, just like the jeans. And it's one of the songs that he will play on Wednesday's show as well. Stay tuned, I shall be back in a little bit with a guest. First off, enjoy this track from Sonic Riders. See you in a bit.
given helping hand, oh Jah, to guide all of us together. People are straying and straying, dividing themselves from each other. There's too many hopeless souls and ragamuffin soldiers. What we need is love, and what we need, everybody, we want vice versa love to all the hungry. Vice versa love, come on and get some. Vice versa love, come on and get it. Vice versa love, to all the rude boys, put down all your guns. The only ammunition for everyone. Mothers, tell your daughters. Fathers, please tell your sons. Just warn them, teach them, tell them, show them that what we need, everybody. Them. Please give an helping hand, oh Jah, to guide all of us together. People are straying and straying, dividing themselves from each other. What we need is love. That's what we need, everybody. We want vice versa love to all the hungry. Vice versa love to all.
Bit of reggae there, bit of taste of what you can expect on Wednesday for Rolly Raccoons, the Raccoon Zone, which will start at 8 PM GMT this Wednesday. Don't miss it, because you will regret. Je ne regrette rien. You don't want to be singing that, do you? Anyway, before that was Gadget Round, which was from Giggin Ruins, Giggin something with a Giggin Hills, or gigging castle or gigging mountains or gigging gigging something or other. I can't, like Amy, I cannot remember what they were called. And before that, well, after that, we had ZZ Top, Woke Up With Wood. Ha ha, what a funny name. Anyway, I nearly forgot earlier on in the news. Spinnix says, why does TRZ have to be on Orange Wednesdays? I agree. You know. Yeah, I think you should move it to a weekend. You probably get more listeners, Rory. Because those of us who are too cheap to spend full price on cinema tickets are sometimes out. Anyway, earlier on, I forgot to mention that if you head over to TSS, and if you've got an Xbox or a PC or anything, or a multiplayer game, this coming weekend will be the start of something that Sarge and Flint have organised, which is a gaming week, I think, which is supposed to coincide with Spring Break, woo, which we don't experience over here in the UK, but you pretty Americans do. So if you fancy competing in something like that, get over to TSS and go to the video games forum and look at the TSS Winter Games. There's going to be a Halo tournament on Friday, Saturday and Sunday. I will probably be appearing on the Sunday because there was going to be a big team battle, 8-on-8. It's going to be 8 staffers against 8 of you Sonic plebeians who hang around TSS. If you fancy your chances, if you think you can have a good go at me, if you think you can, you know, defeat this elite team of staffers, come along, have a go, a bit of a laugh. There's going to be a tournament, a lone wolf tournament on the Friday, it's going to continue on the Saturday, and I think there's also going to be a Team Slayer 4-on-4 as well, so check that out. No doubt, because you lucky Yanks have already got it, like. There will be a Super Smash Bros. Brawl tournament. I do not know what the specifics of that is, so head over to the tournament and find out all about that. Anyway, earlier on, I said I was going to have a guest. I'm just going to ring him now. And it's ringing. Ringing.
Hello.
Hello. There we go. Hello. Who are you?
I'm Urtheart.
It's Mr. Shadow Urtheart, ladies and gentlemen, and he's come to join me on the show and talk about random stuff. How are you this fine Sunday evening, Mr. Urtheart?
Hello.
That good, eh? I hope you can hear. Can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Good. I asked you how you were on this fine Sunday afternoon, evening.
Night. I am not too bad.
You're not too bad, marvellous. How's it going over at the SSN these days? What's going on down there?
Mostly trying to get the watches sorted, obviously. We've started up all the other watches, so we've got Music Watch, Groove Watch, we've got Games Watch, which I do, Right Watch, which Violet does, although I think it was meant to be up this week, but I don't know. And then, of course, there's Strong Bad's normal art watch. So, that's been going down.
Excellent. What does the groove watch involve? That's the one that sounds interesting.
It involves me going to find some of the guys on the audio part of this site who are doing music, getting them to give me some tracks, and then I write some stuff, and give them advice and all that, and then I give it all to Rory so he can show off for a bit. Or Rory Black.
That sounds like Rory, to be honest, doesn't it? So, but can anybody submit music? Can anybody just send in a bit of music, or is it? What's the idea behind that?
For the last couple of weeks, I've picked people just because a lot of the time I've done it on short notice. But yeah, if anybody wants to ask me on it, give us a PM in the in SSMB or email me. My email is somewhere on SSN, so.
Marvellous. Excellent. Thank you very much. Also, before I forget, congratulations on your third place in the Rex Factor All-Time Best competition. Not too shabby, Bronze.
Oh, thank you,
very much. You get a place. You get a place on the podium, at least.
This is true. I must admit, I was never going to win against Anime Girl and Iris. They were a lot better. I blame Rusty.
There's just some people that come in a league of their own, I think, in this case. But there was that, I can't remember who it was by, they played it last week on the Sonic Hour. But the version of My Destiny in, I think it was in Spanish.
Oh yeah, I heard that on
Xbox. I'm glad that wasn't played, because I'm glad that wasn't entered, because
we'd all get pawned.
I think we'd all be up shit creek without a paddle, but never mind.
Including the All Stars.
Including the All Stars. I think all the All Stars would be buggered there, but never mind. I wanted to enter next year, so I was kind of taken back, as I said before, by the fact that Kev says, "Oh yes, I'll be doing a duet with T-Bird in Japanese," and I was like, "Yes." When did this happen? So it's kind of blown out my other idea, which was to round Mini T up from somewhere and sing Tails and Sonic in German.
I've got. Oh no.
But
I don't think I'm going to enter next year. I don't know.
You don't know.
I can find some, one of mine, but.
I'm sure somebody not too long ago was saying they wanted to enter, but they couldn't find it. It'll come back to me later on. Never mind. Anyway,
they've got to come and ask me.
Definitely. But
I'm busy.
Just change your status on MSN, you'll be all right. Although that didn't stop most people. Anyway, the reason I have you on the show is for the new quiz the Sonic fans site. I basically wanted to let the audience find out a little bit more about the people who are operating behind the scenes in TSS, because a lot of people do a lot of work and don't get very much credit, and you're one of them, and there's hundreds of other people who do lots of work and just don't make yourself known. So I'm going to big it up. So here we go, there's okay. ten questions. None of them are particularly taxing. In fact, most of them you can answer as you will, and I probably wouldn't know the best answer, but never mind. So 10 questions, starting from now. Your first question is, what is your favourite drink, Mr. Earthheart?
Dandelion and burdock.
Dandelion and burdock? I don't like dandelion and burdock. I don't know why.
Have you ever tried it?
Yes. Is it made from real dandelions?
I think it depends on which brand you buy, I suppose.
And what the hell is a burdock?
Don't look at me, I just drink it.
You just drink it? Yeah. This is what really upsets me about drinks, the fact that things that we eat, we just eat them, we don't really think about what they are. Question number two, what is your first ever Sonic Girl experience?
It would be the first game I played, Sonic 1 on the Master System. We got it as like a present, and my mum wasn't happy with it, wanted to throw it out, but my dad managed to keep it away and shove it in the cupboard and got it out when she was away, so.
Excellent. I remember when we got our Master System, when we got turned on, we went out to play it first, tried to let our dad play it, and luckily ran into the same enemy three times. The first enemy that you encounter, that little ladybug thing. And he basically ran into that three times, so his game was over within about 50 seconds. So that was alright. Question number three. What is your favourite film of all time?
Oof. I don't watch many films.
You must have a favourite one, though.
The first one that comes to my mind, Return of the Jedi.
It is chosen Empire Strikes Back. Empire Strikes Back's kind of depressing, isn't it? I think it's kind of depressing. Yeah.
I think the reason I chose that one is because first one I watch. I'd never watched New Hope until the special edition remakes. Same with the Empire Strikes Back.
Oh, crazy! So you just watched the end of the series? I suppose it doesn't really matter, does it? They're all little self-contained films, and then. Yeah, well, that's interesting. No,
it still made sense.
Oh, Return of the Jedi is my favourite. I love that film. Because it's got Ewoks in, and none of the other ones have got Ewoks in.
That's true, actually.
Shouldn't really be a decisive one, but, you know, I can talk along to most of the Star Wars films anyway.
You rebel scum. I've just been playing the Lego Star Wars game. That's always fun.
Which one's that? The
Complete Saga one?
Oh yeah, the Lego one.
Yeah, I got the I got it for like £20, so why not?
I like how Obi-Wan Kenobi is such a klutz in those. I didn't. I thought that was a bit cruel, but never mind. Question number four. Who is your favourite Sonic fan artist?
Am I guessing I can't include myself on that one? No. I don't draw enough Sonic fan art, so...
You could say yourself.
I don't do a lot of fan art. Right. The thing is, I don't watch many people either. I can tell you the person that got me into it.
Yeah, sure.
Was a girl who's known as Black Crystal. She's also known as Sky. She used to be a member on the SSNB. She had a character called Crystal the Echidna.
Was that before?
She's long since left now.
I was going to say it must have been well before my time, because I can't remember it. Either.
Yeah, it was before you came on.
Before I existed, back in the dark ages, as we'll call them anyway. Question number 5. What was the last track you listened to, and what do you think of it? Obviously, before you listened to the glory that is Tea Time and
Sonic Hour,
the ham sandwich that is Sonic Hour. What was the last track you listened to, and what did you think of it?
The last track I listened to, because I've just bought a new CD, was, I can't think of the title now, and there's no point in me reading it because it's in Japanese, but it's one of the themes from the new Ace Attorney or Phoenix Wright games DS.
Excellent. And what type of music would you say it is? Because it's like
orchestrated.
It's very orchestrated. I was going to say it's like orchestrated, instrumental or something along those lines. Yes,
I mean, obviously the DS ones are a bit more electronic, but
well, actually I don't find the DS music to be very... I'm really impressed with what the DS actually kicks out, to be honest, half the time.
Oh god, yeah.
So
I must admit, all I meant was the DS version, the one on the DS, the CD they released is much more ornamented, and it's very nice.
Excellent. Would you recommend it to a Felix Wright fan?
Yes, definitely. Any Felix Wright fan should go and buy the CDs, don't download it, that's just cheap.
Ooh, pirates, yeah.
Says he who actually recorded the first two soundtracks by playing through the DS and recording on.
Well, somebody's got to do it, because they don't release half the music, which I find frustrating, but never mind.
Actually, Capcom has released quite a few now. Capcom released most of their games, I think.
So they're all out now. Excellent. We can go out and buy them.
Definitely the Mega Man ones are all out.
Well, don't we know that?
Phoenix.
So. never mind. Anyway, question number 6. If there was to be a live-action Sonic film, who would you cast as Dr. Eggman?
Oh, God. Well, I kind of hope there never would be one, to be honest.
Well, the next question is, would you ever... No, no, I'm just joking.
Now, the other problem is I don't know any actors.
That might be it.
I would Rory Black.
You cast just Rory Black. Oh, dear. Oh, that's... now
you
I definitely don't
panic.
Want to watch that film, so, excellent. Question number 7. Sonic Adventure 1 or Sonic Adventure 2?
Sonic Adventure 2, purely because I played it first.
Cool. Question number 8. What is your all-time favourite piece of Sonic music?
Ooh, another hard one.
Yeah.
Rusty Ruins Saturn version... First or second, they're similar. So.
Good choices. I actually prefer the Mega Drive versions, but they're both are excellent. So
I actually did a remix of the Mega Drive version. I think I've played it to you. I think I've given
yeah,
you.
Yeah, you have. You've sent me that actually. Yeah, it's very trumpety. Speednook says, casting for Dr. Eggman, Danny DeVito. Excellent. I'd have said James Woods, but you know, never mind. Question number 9.
Just one thing, don't play that. You're not going to play that track now, are you?
I hope not. I can't find it. I won't be able to find it. Question number 9.
That's good.
Cream or cheese?
The food or the character?
I don't know. The question just says cream or cheese. It's your choice. I just want you to answer, and then everyone else can judge.
I'm gonna go with cheese purely
go
because.
Cheese. Interesting.
I like cheese.
You like cheese. Question. Finally, question number 10. A hedgehog, a fox, and a echidna walk into a bar. What happens?
Well, apart from getting pissed and probably blowing the whole place up after thinking half the people are Dr. Eggman.
Yeah, I think they're all in their age as well, so yeah.
They'd probably crash the place, I'd just guess.
They'd probably never mind. Anyway, I'm not sure whether they go off.
I think there's a lot of strange looks.
Definitely that. Anyway,
we're gonna have to try that sometime. Get free cosplaying as I'm walking to the bar.
Hedgehog. A man dressed as a hedgehog, a fox, and a guy walking through. Not all three. Three different guys. But never mind. Anyway, you have completed the vocal assault course that is the Tea Time questionnaire, and congratulations. And I hope people know you a little bit more. Anyway, it is almost time for
what
me.
What was my score?
You full marks, and I think everyone might draw with you every week.
I
have to buy a lot of prizes. Never mind. Anyway, it is nearly time to finish. I will be back next week, same time, same place, following the Sonic Hour, which was actually, there was a threesome today in the Sonic Hour, not in that way, but you know.
How many more viewers do you think they'd get if they actually did?
But yes, there's three in the Sonic Hour today, so hopefully that'll be a reoccurring theme. It seemed to work a little bit more, rather than just...
I still say there's a battle between Rory and Joe.
Yes.
For dominance.
for that second place.
Dominance over. To sit at dominance for their patrol over Sven.
Oh dear. Girlfriend versus brother fight. So that'll be interesting to see. So I think they should do that next week. Just see how it goes. And run it next week. Anyway.
Now you have to tell them that because obviously they're not listening. They never listen.
No, he was on halfway through my show. So I guess...
This is true, and then he left.
Then he left. He got bored. He has better things to do. In his busy life, you know. So popular, isn't he? He's had his feet amputated anyway, so I don't know how he's getting about. He must get carried everywhere. So,
Nah, you just get one of those swivelly chairs with wheels on the bottom and just go, get a stick and go...
Just push in places. Like
or it's Rory's job, one of the two.
It probably is. He probably does that stupid laugh everywhere. He goes, oh, whatever the hell he does.
Well, you know he does that everywhere. He always does it when we're on the community meetups.
Oh, he's just... He's a crazy fool! Right, I'm going to end this before it carries on, because this is what usually happens. I will be back next week. There are some other shows in the week which currently eluded my mind. Oh god, who's currently broadcasting?
Rory on Wednesday.
Rory Raccoon's on Wednesday. He's at 8.
Speednox on Monday.
Yep, Speednox is tomorrow. At 7? I think it's 7.
I forgot it's Sunday.
Yeah, it's 7, so tune in for him. Thursday might be Iceman, probably won't be Iceman.
Dark Noise as well, isn't it?
And Dark Noise at 7. Is he at 7 or is he later?
Don't look at me, I must admit, I don't usually get to listen to it because I'm working.
Speednox is 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Yeah, Dark Noise is on Thursday. It's usually very hyperactive. I usually have to take a lot of sugar before I listen to that show so I can bounce around the room as well. On Friday, you have The Tiger's Eye with the aforementioned Raw Eye Black. On Saturday, you have Turbo Drive Live at 11 p.m. if you like staying up late in the UK. Or if you've got nothing better to do while eating your tea in the US. I've been T-Bailed. He's been Mr. Shadow Earthheart. Thank you very much for coming on the show to do the...
Bye-bye.
I shall see you all next week, and we shall go out on a couple of unusual tracks. Actually go out on today. And I thought, well, I usually play a long song at the end. You know, I can't be bothered to do that. So I had a look, and I thought... Well, everyone's waving their arms in the chat room going, oh, I like J-pop, I like J-rock and things. So I'm going to play you a couple of J-rock tracks. The first one is by a... Breathe In, Japanese industrial electronic metal punk band called the Madcaps New Markets. You may be familiar with them. It's a single released a few years back called Pulse. It is quite trippy. And followed straight after that is J Cross J. For those of you who don't know, I love bigging up this album. It's the work of the infamous Johnson out, working with Junko What's-Her-Face. And they released an EP a little while ago with 6 songs on it. I can't read the title, so I'm just going to play this song. It's one of the tracks on the EP. If you like it, go and hunt the EP. I don't know where to get it. I can't even get in touch with John these days. He won't reply to my emails. I think he's probably hiding somewhere. Well, he's moving back to Tokyo because Sega virtually upped sticks in the US and are moving their operation back to Tokyo. So he's moving back. So I don't know, John, if you're listening, I'm lonely. Email me, please. Anyway.